then by all means, do it. But until then, cease and desist, travel across his property only to get to your property. Do you understand that?
I understand what you're saying. I don't agree with it.
I don't care.
However,
I'm not done talking. Here's the skin. If you continue to do what you're doing without providing proof that you can do it, and I'm giving him the opportunity too to provide proof that he cannot, I mean that you cannot do it, as well as providing proof from you that you can, okay? Until that time, don't do anything. If you do, I will research it, and I will, if there are any charges pending for criminal mischief to someone's property, I will ensure that that happens.
How about criminal threatening?
Pardon me?
About criminal threatening, a man chasing me around with shovels, slamming this machine with shovels. Long before I ever come up over that hill, he was
right. We had an agreement
out there.
We had an agreement to which you violated.
No, I searched for you yesterday.
I have it documented that you told me that you were not doing anything outside the wood line.
I came looking for you yesterday. Right. I cannot spend the entire day.
Did you provide proof to me?
I certainly came with a proof.
Did you provide proof to
and
me?
I considered that a request.
Yes or no?
I considered that a request.
Did you provide?
I considered that a request.
Did you talk again without listening? You're interrupting. That's rude.
I'm sorry.
Did you provide proof to me prior to doing any work outside the wood line? Yes or no? It's a yes or no thing.
No. However, I considered that a request.
So having not provided it to me, you violated your agreement.
I don't believe that was an agreement. I believe it was a request on your part. I think it was unreasonable to hold me up.
Now,
I believe it was unreasonable.
Now it is an order.
Okay,
to not do any work. Do not paint lines on the road. Don't do anything to this man's property other than travel back and forth it. To go to your property. Until you can provide proof to me that you have permission to do that work or alter the right of way.
Okay. I have the proof in my van. However, I'm waiting for pro rental. They said they would be here at 7:30. They are not here.
And you're right. And I understand you doing this. And I am going to ask for a copy of that because your voice is on there understanding what I'm telling you.
You already have a copy with your tape.
Right, but I can get a copy of yours. Not a problem. You okay. Understand that? You understand what I told you?
That what?
You are not to alter his property in any way until you can provide me proof.
I can provide you proof right now if you want to walk out and...
I'm not walking. You bring it to me.
I believe this is an unreasonable request.
It's not unreasonable. I asked you that the other day.
I have provided proof over the years on the same issue. I am not doing anything that I have not done for 10 years. And there has been many officers here.
Right. And I have never seen anything that would indicate to me that you or they, the prior residents here or the current residents here, have proof one way or the other that this road can be altered.
This road has been here since 1906.
Right. Have you ever provided to us...
There's no proof that they can alter it into a lawn instead of a road.
Quite frankly, it was very visible to me with the prior tenants that were here and with the current tenants here that there was a road down through there. Very visible.
It was after Sonny Cooley and I improved the road.
But were you not then made to remove some of the materials from the road?
Certainly not. Never.
So anyway, when you can provide stuff to me documented either through the deed, which I would assume would be the best way to prove it, or anything that you have that says that you can alter the road, the right of way, to include this property or the Pettit's property, then I'd be happy to review it. Civil matter that you have to prove that you can do it, or he has to prove that you can't. So rather than agitating, because if it's proven that you can't or don't have the right to do that, you'll have to repair whatever has been done to his property.
Certainly. Let the man get a lawyer. If I've done any damage and it's against civil law, then he has a very good lawsuit. And you're a very good witness. And he may sue me. However, this man, every time I come up here before I've done any work, and I have mentioned this to you, this man has been threatening me for over a year. He's been keeping this basketball hoop in the right of way.
Actually, it looks where the dead grass was.
That's where it was this year. Last year, it was right between those pins.
From what I could tell this year, and I don't have any proof from last year, that it was right on the limited right-of-way distance, so, 12 and a half feet.
So, are you arguing his point, or
choose your words carefully.
My point is that last year, the man had the basketball hoop there.
This is an ongoing thing. Right.
And I have mentioned this to the police department. And I have mentioned this to the police department.
Mm-hmm.
I went and I got the man a copy of the survey, dropped it off at his office.
Survey is one thing, right?
And
proof of being able to alter the right of way is another.
This is about him obstructing my right of way. And then moving on. And threatening me over a basketball hoop.
At this particular point in time, I'm getting wet, and we've already conversed, and until you can provide me with proof that you can alter this right-of-way, his property.
I am under a threat of arrest if I do any further work on my property. On my
his property is your right-of-way, okay? And until you can provide proof to me, I'm asking you to cease and desist doing work or altering his property in any way.
Okay.
Painting lines on it, defacing it, tearing up the lawn, which is the right of way.
I have never torn up his lawn. I have done
the right of way.
Then my
right
road,
of way, which he mowed
which is
back there.
An easement. A right of way is just
right.
Another terminal.
Well,
pardon
me. As I said, I'm getting wet, and if your battery hasn't run out yet, I'm sorry, but I'm leaving.
Pretty good battery. Thanks for coming.